This every day, right? Every time we do this, you're drinking complimentary Remy. You understand that? So I need you to make some noise for that. Make some noise for Remy Martin, please. So, without further ado, what I'm going to do is I'm going to introduce your host for the evening. He called him by the name of Charlamagne the God. Give it up for my man Charlamagne, please.
Yep. Hey, welcome to the Remy Martin Producers Series. Only Remy can get me out my curb on a Tuesday night, but this is a very worthwhile event because we all love music, and without the producers, we wouldn't have no music. So this event gives up-and-coming producers a chance to come and get some game from the best. And tonight, we got one of the best here. He goes by the name of Honorable C.N.O.T.E.
What it do?
What it do, y'all?
Now, you got a very impressive resume, my brother. Run down some of your joints.
ASAP Rocky M's featuring Lil Wayne. I did 2 Chainz Free Bass. I did Future, Long Live the Pimp, ASAP Rocky, and ASAP Ferg and Future, New Level.
I think they know that one. Y'all know I'm on a New Level, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Migos, Freak No More. Let's go.
And you from Michigan originally, right?
Yeah, Benton Harbor, Michigan.
How did a kid from Michigan link up with like all those rappers from down south and rappers from Harlem and stuff?
No, I'm a hustler. Okay. You know, we know how to move and shake and move around and keep good personal relationships with the artists and just continue on working.
It didn't just start that easy though.
No, man, it took a lot of praying and a lot of things. But to make the long story short, you know what I'm saying? Network and not work, go hard, go home.
So how did Gucci Mane meet
you? One of my homeboys moved to Atlanta from Michigan. You know what I'm saying? He was asking me to send him some a beat CD. I thought he wanted to rap to him. So I'm like, I ain't sending you no beats, bro. So he kept on asking me, and finally I sent it to him. And it landed in the hands of the Franchise Boys manager. And he worked for Big Cat at the time. So when he got it to Gucci, I was just like, you know, it can happen for me. You know, because when you grow up in the hood, it's kind of like, you don't know if it can happen for you because everybody's so negative. It's like, oh, you can't do that. But, just that one thing made me kind of like take it up and move to a better.
Oh, you're looking for what they call a case to have some optimism. So that was evidence that, you know what?
It can happen.
Wore it up. So you went right down to Atlanta. You just packed up everything?
No, it didn't happen quite like that. You know what I'm saying? You know, it was time to be like doubting myself, but it was so much stuff happening. Like, you know, me being in a project selling weed or whatever. This isn't stuff or stuff. It's just like, hey man, it was just time to go. All the signs pointed straight to the mountains.
Now, the tree your mom moved y'all out the hood. She said you gotta move to a predominantly white area to keep y'all out of trouble.
Yeah, that's when I first started making beats.
You ain't had shit else to do.
Nothing.
Yeah.
It was like, you know what I'm saying? They kicked us out of school and everything. Didn't have nothing to do. So,
what was your first piece of equipment?
My first piece of equipment was the DR5.
I don't even know what that is. The producer's here.
My brother went half on it right there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? The DR5 is made by Roland. It has a lot of pads. I used to ride around with it to make beats in my car.
So is that like a computer program?
It's not even a computer. No, it's analog. Straight analog. But this was in the 90s. All analog.
What was the next piece of equipment?
It was the QY7, and then from the QY7, I came up to the Yamaha MOTC.
What would you tell these up-and-coming producers now what they need to get started? Because a lot of these guys are just on, like, computer programs now. But you actually know how to play instruments.
I'm slick and geek. I'm slick and nerd with it. But I would tell them to keep grinding, man. Listen to the radio and try to beat what's on the radio. You know what I'm saying? Don't compete with nobody from, like, their neighborhood. It ain't worth it. You know what I'm saying? You always... Like, even when I was in the hood, I always competed with, like, Kanye West. Like, I hear something they did on the Blueprint,
yeah,
and nobody has seen me for, like, a month. Like, what's he know that? I'm in there making beats trying to beat them.
But you're trying to be ahead of the curve,
yeah,
though, right?
Trying to be always. Always better. You know what I'm saying? It's competition.
That's interesting you said listen to the radio, though, because a lot of producers be like, they don't want to make what's on the radio at all.
Right. So if you don't want to make what's on the radio, you're going to make what's better than what's on the radio.
Gotcha.
Like, when I listen to the radio, I listen to how the kick hit, how the snare hit. It's not the exactly sound, but it's sounds that's in the radio. Like, if you listen to New Level, it's like another level. It's like what I call stadium music. Like, when it hit, you just going to react to it. So that's what I've been looking for.
Who taught you how to play instruments? I heard you play the keyboard.
I don't play the keyboard. I taught myself the black keys. It was something that I sat down and I played it with. So I can play the black keys, but I'm not like 100% great with it.
Do you like live instrumentation?
Yeah, live instrumentation is where it's at. Like most of my beats, when I try to put them together, I try to make them like live sound. You know what I'm saying?
Do you feel like you've made your hit yet?
No. It's hard. You know what I'm saying? Like,
is that on you or the artist though?
I don't know. Sometimes, you know, even when I think it's me, I think it's too much in the beat, I start subtracting things. That's why I like working with artists, because if you with an artist and you come up with a melody, they come up with a song, and you're not going to add, like, a lot of sounds in it.
All right, so, no, what we actually about to do, man, my man C.N.O., well, first of all, how hard is it? I want you to tell the producers that's out there right now, they still grinding, they're trying to get placements. How hard is it to get that one placement?
It depends on your work ethic and how you move. Like, your one placement could be somebody that you just work with, that you grew up with, and then blow up. Or it could be that, you know, you intern and go up. It's about how you move, you know what I'm saying? It took me a long time. It took me about 5, 6, 7 years to get my first placement. And even after that, I still was broke, you know what I'm saying?
Were you working with local artists prior to that?
Oh, yeah. That is, you know, when I moved to Atlanta, I was working with, like, NFL players, track players, you know, they kept the bills paid, but at the end of the day, I'm going to hit.
And you was giving away music.
Yeah, like you always, like, I don't try to give away music, I try to borrow. You know what I'm saying? Like, if I do this for you, you gotta come back on the return, and you know what I'm saying? It's a system that I came up with.
Would you suggest up and coming producers to do that? Because a lot of these guys, they do their beat, and they're like, fuck that, I ain't giving nothing away.
I mean, 10% of nothing is nothing, you know what I'm saying? 100% of nothing is nothing.
Absolutely. So what we gonna do right now, my man Honorable C.N.O.T.E, you got some production you gonna play, right?
Oh yeah. I'll play a couple of songs that I produced. Mind y'all know what it is.
You'll give us a few secrets on some of the sounds in them and all that?
Yeah.
All right, let's get that going.
What's this? This 2 Chainz Freebase. This is actually me rapping on the intro of it.
We came from nothing, so they came like it's nothing. Told you from the introduction, I came from the pain and suffering. Two pit bulls and a tech nine. Tech nine, you just deal for me all the time. Tell the guard if you come up in my mummy yard, I'ma shoot that motherfucker to a get time. Kick through the truck, got 6 times. Fifth time.
Tough tune.
That song, that particular song was Free Bass. When 2 Chainz was working on the album Free Bass, and he told me, he was like, yo, C.N.O.T.E, you know I ain't got nothing from you on here. Like, that's how he tried me. So I was just like, yeah, I'll be back. So what I did is I went home, I constructed the beat, I made the hook, and I brought it to him. I was just like, yo, this is it right here. And he heard it, he lost his mind. We was on the tour bus. We was on a Lil Wayne tour. And that's just how it came about.
So is it easier to make a track for an artist after you work with them? Like, you kind
of course. You know exactly what they gonna do. Like, 2 Chainz, he like to rap over loops. And then I go back in and put the breakdowns and do all that. So it's easier for him to construct the song just off of the song just looping. He go crazy.
So that beat really couldn't work for nobody else, bro.
I don't know, he killed it. After that, I was doing it. Like, yeah, we're going.
What was some of the equipment you used to make that? Your bass is off.
Yeah, I use the MPC, but it's still drums. Like I told you, when I studied the radio, I studied drums, and I wanted to be better. So that's why I like. I like hard hitting drums, different sequences.
You got another one?
Yeah, that's one.
Who you got?
ASAP Rocky Hymns.
Okay.
One time for ASAP, yeah. Let's go. What's this I see? Niggas tryna act like G's. Got A$AP, got Birdie with me, it's a new day, no black eyed peas. That's that shit. Yeah, that's that shit. Motherfucker better blast that shit. Bitches nigga throw all the kilos. Like I make sales at a Blico. Sheet note, went to ATL for my C.N.O.T.E. Remember I ain't never had no home. Now I got a penthouse in the beach home. Back when I was rocking these, I was trapping up at least like 3 phones. 3 years ain't a plan. Then I paid myself and I gave myself a band. Way before I became myself, I like to thank myself because I made myself a man. It's like lately I ain't myself. I'd rather hang myself before I blame myself. Until I throw on a dress with the pinstripes. Know the one to put the booty on skin tight, that's right. Yeah, you that shit. Yeah, move that shit.
That was my boy A$AP Rocky teaching the way, produced by me.
You still making them records that back in the day would have the trunks rattling.
Yeah,
so they don't do that. You don't really have the speakers in the cars no more like that. So what's the inspiration to have all that bass now?
Stadium music. I just like if you look at how the EDM crowd is, and like they still use the hard bass. It's kind of different, but like I promise you, like that's what it is. It's just like it just changes from time to time. So I think it went from the trunk of our cars to stadiums. Ain't nobody really just realized it yet, but I think that's where it's going. So that's why I go for it.
Now, a record like that, did you already have the beat done and give it to A$AP?
Yeah, I got the beat done. I gave it to Yams. Yams gave it to
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace to homie Yams. He seen the whole vision. He was like, yo, we gonna get Wayne on this. This is gonna be crazy. So, you know, it just, yeah, rest in peace to the homie Yams.
You use the same equipment for that record?
Everything is the NPC Renaissance.
Okay.
So yeah, I definitely use the NPC Renaissance and Pro Tools. Because the NPC Renaissance and Pro Tools is kind of like they married. When you producing a song, if you can be on bar 32, the NPC Renaissance is going to take you right to bar 32 and you can insert whatever you need to insert for that.
Is that how you get the real chunky sounds with the NPC? Because I don't feel like you can get that on a computer. Either computer, bro.
It's the NPC and the sounds you use. You have to train your ear to listen to the sounds, you know what I'm saying?
Let's get one more, man. You got one more?
Oh, yeah. This the one. I got one, and then I'm going to bring my homeboy Tate up here. We got another one, you know what I'm saying?
Who's this that you about to play?
This is New Level featuring Future. A$AP Ferg.
We heard about it.
I'm going to break the beat down, too, so.
Yeah.
Broke apart. Like Future sent his session in, and then Ferg sent his session in. So I actually had to put the song together.
Gotcha.
So it was something as me, like as a producer, knowing Pro Tools and learning Pro Tools and knowing exactly how I want my sound to be.
Was it custom for Ferg?
No. What had happened was they had heard the.
What had happened was that meant it was for somebody else who didn't pay for the beat.
Huh?
That means somebody didn't pay for the beat originally.
You know what I need to do.
Yeah,
pretty much.
So it was for somebody else originally?
Huh?
It was for somebody else originally?
Well, yeah, like 3 or 4 other artists rapped on the beat, but it didn't. It wasn't that.
Oh, it didn't sound right.
Yeah, you know, sometimes when you can have a hot beat, but the song don't be all the way complimenting the beat. So when Ferg sent me that, I was like, yo, it gotta be yours. Like, I know what that is.
See, I always wonder about that. So if you're a producer and you give out beats to a bunch of different artists, if you don't like it, you got the right to be like, nah.
Nah, I don't want to sell it to you. Wow. I think that's one of my things too, man. Like at being as a producer, like I might hold myself back doing that too. Cause somebody, it might be a hit, but if I don't like it, like I really ain't, Slick ain't gonna answer my phone.
Gotcha. So what's your gauge other than you? You got like a production team, you got people around you?
Yeah, I got the Honorable Court, but you know, mostly I just built that this year.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? It's about working smarter, not harder, but like all the songs you did was 100% that you heard tonight was 100% produced by me.
So what about when artists come to you and they be like, yo, I want that new level sound. I want a beat just like that.
I've been moving around the South so much, like for all these years, they don't come at me like that. Like usually the artists that I work with, they already know what it is. Like almost anything that I pull up, they're gonna try to rap over or they gonna do whatever.
So and you never try to duplicate the same
beat. I hate that.
Right.
Passion.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so that's the thing I did. Like on this beat right here, the bass on it is kinda like it's tough, but it's the kick that make it hit hard like that. You know what I'm saying? But the bass is like the undertone, and this beat, the new level, the strings, it's one string on here that just carry the beat that make it do it. It's this one right here.
Y'all paying attention, producers? Y'all know what he's talking about, right?
This one sound right here carries the whole beat. Right here is what you. That's the, you don't even know it's in the beat until I solo it, but you know it's in there. So if I put the bass on top of that, now you hear, it's like you getting ready to just go crazy. So right here, I knew I had something, you know what I'm saying? So right here, that right there, that get people ready, that's that pump music, you know what I'm saying? That's what I call that stadium. So by the time the 808 hit on it. I'm not going to overthink, because if I hear you something rapping, I'm going to stop everything I'm doing and tell you to rap over it, and then I'm going to go back. And so if I hear your vocals, I'm not going to overproduce it.
Gotcha. So if you had a piece of advice for these up-and-coming producers that's here right now, and been sitting here listening to you for the past 20 minutes, what would it be?
I'll work everybody. Period. Like, you're going to find your style within your work. Ain't no shortcut around work. I sit there and watch Gucci do 10 songs before he got locked up a night. And I watched Future do another 10, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, you can't get past the work. If you lazy as an artist, it's gonna show. If you lazy as a producer, it's gonna show. But if you put that work in, they gonna hear.
What about when it comes to like working with like artists in your hood? Because everybody ain't gonna get the Gucci's immediately. So what about the local artists in your area? Is that a good way to hone your craft?
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Before I even left, I had a record label that me and my brother had, self-made records. I did the whole album. We get four albums that's out of circulating. We sold them out the trunk. I did all the production on it. You know what I'm saying? So that came from, you know what I'm saying? That, and also people in the hood gonna keep it real. Like we'll be playing Lil Jon was popping at the time. We'll play that and the club going crazy. One of my songs come on, everybody need to play. I'm like, man, that's motivation. It's just motivation to get better. You know, I ain't never take that like the wrong way.
That's good. A lot of people would put their music out and people leave the dance floor, they'd be like, fuck, maybe I suck at this shit.
Yeah.
Did you ever thought you felt like
never,
that?
I never thought I sucked at it though, man. It's something I always wanted to do since a kid.
Absolutely.
So yeah, and so we basically what I did was, you hear that beat? It's a lot of, it's not that many instruments in it, but it got a bounce. But I worked with this artist that signed the 300 Take Cold Bang. Did his new single. It's called Oh My.
You hear that?
Yeah, he here.
Take Cold Bang, bro. Come here, my brother.
So this is my bro.
You said you signed the 300?
Yeah, this is my bro, Take Cold Bang.
What's up, man? How you? You good?
Give it up to Take Cold Bang, ladies and gentlemen.
You can't just play the record now. You got to perform it if you want.
Oh, yeah.
We got a mic for you, brother. Right here in my hand.
How y'all motherfuckers doing? I'm drunk as hell. I took my albuterol before I got here, so we were more time to fuck up. Honorable C.N.O.T.E, Baltimore in the building, Lil Hazy.
So basically what I did, I started off this sound. And when he heard this, he automatically went crazy. You see them drums? This kind of remind me like of some African shit. You know what I'm saying? Like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
That's the African shit.
Lady the flow this, oh my, this for, I should do the dance. Hey, oh my, said she did the shit before, yeah, I can tell her no lie. Hey, oh my, I should do the dance. Oh my, said she did the shit before, yeah, I can tell her no lie. Oh my, shorty love it twice, I had her coming both times.
What?
If I ever had it, best believe that whole mind.
What?
Said she got a nigga buddy bitching all the time. Looking for his missus, got her missing all the time. Do it all day, never open up the blinds. Put her on them drugs, let him open up her mind. Going back to back to back. Got me spending money on it, going rack to rack to rack. Got the Remy out the kitty and a couple extra straps. This is how she wanna say she only get it from the back. All because I'm younger thug, youngest nigga in the. Never leave the cripple, so I put it on her. Bust it open for the kid and I'ma put it on a snack. Talk about a freak, I'm dressed, she put it on and it's a wrap. Oh my, how she do the dance? Oh my, said she did this shit before, y'all can tell her no lie. Oh my, how she do the dance? Oh my, said she did this shit before, y'all can tell her no lie. Oh, hey, they let me in, here I go. I mess with that snow, all my bitches on go. She up on the ceiling, slide down to the floor. And just cause she dance, that don't make her a hoe. I pull in, I count in, I'm throwing it up. She nasty, told me put my thumb in her butt. I'm in it to win it, I'm all in her gut. That ass is so bad, I see that from the front. Got the shooter with me, now we low and strap to strap to strap. If they looking for me, I ain't hard to find a way I'm at. Probably get her ass up with me, thinking black on black on black. Going dumb on every track, let's take it back to Shepard Pratt. Yeah, yeah. She love that dance that I do. I pay for that pussy, drop bands for that true. Oh yeah, she love that dance that I do. I pay for that pussy, drop bands on that true. Hey, I should do the dance. Oh my, said she did this shit before, yeah, I can tell there's no lie. Oh my, I should do the dance. Oh my, said she did this shit before, yeah, I can tell there's no lie. Oh my, I should do the dance. Oh.
What I was trying to, that's what he rapped to, but that's not how the initial record ended. You know what I'm saying? That, it didn't have the hi-hats and none of that. But what I just wanted to show y'all, it could take just a loop for somebody to come up with something and make it happen.
So you gave him a loop and then he laid the vocals?
Yeah, he laid the vocals and then after the vocals, after he left, I went back and added some stuff.
Gotcha. Yeah. Yo, make some noise for the honorable C.N.O.T.E, y'all. Where
can they get at you if they need to get at you, man?
You can follow me at Honorable C.N.O.T.E, all social networks, websites, whatever it is. And I tell all up and coming producers every time we do this, man, take the opportunity to network with guys like C.N.O.T.E. He's gonna be in here floating around drinking on this good Remy.
I did.
So take the time to chop it up with him, you know, get some jewels from him. You got some on the stage, but maybe he can tell you something one-on-one that can help you out a lot, all
right? That's right.
Now we about to start the Remy Martin Producers Series, right, Raymo?